a great song, wasn't it? And for those of you who were singing along, can you believe that was more than 20 years ago? Well, that's nearly a quarter of a century.
Who is it?
It's Alma.
Well, Edie, Revere Magazine, scoop them again. Sly Stallone's divorce settlement is all over page six.
The match Rocky couldn't win. I didn't know Stallone was getting a divorce.
Neither does he. But psychic Roberta Stump sees it in his future. She also saw the settlement.
Oh, look what she's getting. The artwork, the Beverly Hills home, his $100,000 stretch Mercedes. I remember when he got that.
It was the day we bought the bath towels and they'd thrown the washcloths for 99 cents.
Those were nice towels.
Yeah.
Look, 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 a photo of Barracuda Johnson getting in his tour bus.
Nice buns.
You should see him wiggle in concert. They're insured for $500,000.
I'd like to be the appraiser.
Look, Linda Evans coming out of Georgia is wearing the same dress she wore to the People's Choice Awards. What does she think? No one remembers.
Mr. Blackwell did. Check page 10.
I hate her hair like that.
She probably did it herself. I'm telling you, these people need someone to tell them what looks good. Check out Cher.
Remember her with Sonny?
Oh. Listen, the girls are coming over for bridge tonight. Can you make it?
Alma, it's Friday night in New York City. Did it ever occur to you that I might have a date?
We go through this every Friday night. Are you coming or not?
Yeah. Listen, I'd love to stay in Dish, but I gotta go to work. I'm doing Manhattan today.
Oh. Can I have some more of that blush you gave me?
Oh, so Hank liked it, huh?
Well, he said it made me look like a hooker.
Well, then why do you want it? Oh. Hi, I'm Edie Gruber with New Beginning Cosmetics. Hi, I'm Edie Gruber. Oh, hi, I'm Edie Gruber with New...
Who is it?
Edie Gruber, New Beginning Cosmetics.
Come on in.
As you know, at New Beginning, we don't just sell makeup. We sell, you guessed it, a new beginning. And don't forget, long after the sale is made, we continue to work with you. Because what we're all about at New Beginning is making everyone a little more beautiful. Yep, that's what we're all about at New Beginning. A more beautiful world. That's us, New Beginning. Goodbye.
Well, shouldn't we at least look through some of your samples?
Listen, are you really going to put me through this? In 2 short hours, I have been abused in 17 different languages. What are you going to do, huh? Are you going to sit me down and tell me that you have everything and I have nothing?
Oh, that's not true at all.
Is that you on the wall?
Yes.
You're a model?
Yes.
Then we both know it is true, don't we?
Yes.
Before I go out there and get another door slammed in my face, I just gotta ask you, what's it feel like to have no problems?
I have problems.
Name one.
I have a heck of a time gaining weight.
Why would you think I don't have problems?
Well, I do. A real one.
I'm waiting.
My boyfriend and I are fighting.
Oh!
Wait a second! You think that was easy for me to say to a total stranger? Well, it wasn't. You asked for a problem, I gave you one, and now I want to talk about it.
Listen, lady, I gotta go to work.
Boy, that's so typical. Y'all might not know this, but I'm not from New York.
Really?
No, I'm not. And where I come from, if you're nosy enough to squeeze a problem out of somebody, You're committed to listening to it.
You say you and your boyfriend are having problems.
We've been dating for 2 years now, and he refuses to make a commitment. I'm 29 years old, and I want to have children. I don't want to wake up one day and be 30 and find myself a lonely, childless old spinster. Why are guys so scared to talk about marriage?
Well, is he getting the milk? Of course he's getting it.
He's just so insensitive. Do you know how we spent the anniversary of our first date? Watching the Knicks game on TV with the doorman. He finally paid me a little attention at halftime. He said, "What do you think, Frank? Some babe, huh?"
He did that to you? To that? Whoa. This really is eye-opening. I mean, I thought they only did that to people who are beautiful on the inside. Good students who just weren't popular no matter how hard they tried.
I was really hurt.
People who try just a little too hard to be what men want them to be. Smile when there's nothing funny. Wait by the phone, they never call. And believe me, my number's out there. No, they don't care, you know? You give them what they want one time. And then they figure that, are you okay? Oh, yeah, I'm fine. You were saying?
Well, I just walked out, and I moved back in here, and I threw the stuff you kept over here in a box.
And now you're feeling bad over all those things you said to him.
Well, I didn't say anything to him. But he should know I don't like being treated that way. Nobody likes that.
You'd be surprised at the things men don't know. I mean, you'd think after 10 years my husband would know to leave the toilet seat down.
I wish mine remembered to put it up.
I've been there, too. Does yours ever leave his dirty, smelly clothes lying around?
He puts them right on top of the hamper.
Mine, too.
He'd never think to open the lid and just put the clothes inside.
No, right. A toilet seat they can raise, but a hamper lid, forget it.
Must be biological.
Who would ever thought that you and me would have guys with so much in common?
There, you see, I knew if we talked long enough, we'd find something that you have that I don't. A husband.
Well... Not anymore. Stanley left me for an 18-year-old girl. They went to Madrid.
Madrid is beautiful.
I wouldn't know.
Well, it is.
Thank you. Listen, you know what you gotta do? You gotta sit down with this guy and tell him what's on your mind.
Oh, I can't.
Why not?
I don't know. I guess I've just never been good at confrontation.
Well, nobody likes confrontation, but you can't just sit back and be a victim. You know, when Stanley left, I could have just let him go, laid in bed, cried, and thought about all the things I should have said to him. Well, I didn't. I got up, I ran to the airport, cried, and told him all those things. Listen, I beat the stench out of that man's socks for 10 years, and I let everyone on that plane to Madrid know it. It was a 10-hour flight, and he had nowhere to hide. That's how I like to remember my Stanley.
That's a very moving story.
Well, it might not relate to everybody. But the point is, we gotta let these guys know they can't walk all over us. Well, sure, they can. But we don't have to lie down for them, right? Now, if I were you, I'd corner this guy and lay into him. You know how to really get him? You know all that milk he's been getting from you? Tell him his pail is rusty.
You'd really say that to Barracuda Johnson?
Barracuda Johnson? The singer? The rock star? Cuda Johnson? And you were Maris McKay, the fashion model he stole away from the ski jumping champion in Gestad in choir September 6, 1984. And might that be Cuda stuff in that box on the desk?
That's it.
They think they're so special. Well, next time you see him, tell him Edie Gruber used his shirt to wipe off her makeup. They think they're gods.
I'm gonna ask you a big favor. You see, Cuda has a pretty bad temper.
Oh, I know, like that tantrum he threw in the ballroom of the Ritz Hotel in Paris 3 years ago.
Were you there?
No, but people was.
Edie, I'm going to tell Cuda to be here tonight at 7:30, and I'm going to tell him how I feel. Would you mind coming over, you know, to sort of make sure that I don't chicken out?
Me? Here? With Barracuda Johnson?
Yes, please.
Okay. But only if you do me a favor. You see, I have such contempt for this man because of the way he treats you that I would like the honor of disposing of this refuse.
That would be great.
So, see you at 7:30.
Thanks again, Edie.
No problem, Maris.
Bye.
It's time.
Don't touch me. It took them 4 hours to make me look like this. It takes 2 seconds to destroy it. Well, I'm ready. Wish me luck.
Oh, get his autograph.
Get his picture.
Get his underpants.
That's enough. Don't tire Edie out. Here, take these and shove them. Go in. Go. Go.
Get there, pathetic. Edie, you look beautiful.
Thanks.
Oh, promise me you'll remember every detail, every word he says.
Alma, it's finally gonna happen. You know, New York is a cruel city, because the good life is right out there. I mean, you can see it, you can smell it, but every time you reach out to touch it, someone smacks your hand away. Well, not anymore. Tonight, my hands are gonna be wrapped around it. I feel like a princess.
Here's the elevator.
Alma, I think my luck is finally gonna change. Yes, and I'm bleeding. Where's Cuda?
He's not here.
Good, good. When he gets here, we take no prisoners. You tell him what you expect from this relationship, and if he doesn't like it, let him look for someone new.
He's not coming, Edie. I phoned to let him know not to be late. Frank, the doorman, answered. He said Cuda's gone to Paris, and he'll call you when he gets back. He didn't even have the nerve to call me himself. What a wad.
Why do we let them do this to us? What do they think we are? Dirt?
I mean, are we supposed to just sit here and wait till he comes back from Paris? Well, we're not. We're going out tonight. I got us dates.
Dates?
Edie, you're looking a little new wave. Come on, I'll help you get fixed up, and we'll find you something to wear that's not all ripped up. Edie, do you have a dog?
Wonderful.
Yeah, get this. Dad tells me, debutante or not, she's a harlot. So he ships me off to Harvard. I come back, and she's my mother.
You know, in high school, I was dating this guy named Walter, and my best friend Rhonda was going
to... Ah, here's our waiter.
Well, have we decided?
I can't decide between the beef Wellington and the tiger prawns.
The tiger prawns.
Here? Oh, definitely.
Very good, madam. And you?
I'm on the fence between the scampi and the filet mignon.
You know, that sounds good. I'll change to the scampi. Edie, why don't you order the filet and we'll go halves?
Great.
Very good. Gentlemen?
They'll both have the prawns.
Of course.
So, Maris, where are you vacationing this year?
Don't you think you should pay some attention to Edie?
Me? I think since Mark is her escort, he should have to talk to her.
Me? You're sitting next to her.
This is ridiculous, Cubby. You're her date.
So, Edie, do you know any good vacation spots?
Well, about 5 years ago, Stanley and I visited the Hershey plant. You know, in Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Oh, really?
It was fascinating. They showed us how they make everything.
Did they give you any chocolate?
No.
I'd like to go there sometime.
Listen, Maris, instead of that, Brad Palmer from the Vineyard, he's having a birthday party tonight at the Palladium.
Yes, that's right. You know, Cher and Kurt Russell and that Miami Vice guy,
Don Johnson?
Yes, that's him. Well, they're all going to be there. Why don't the three of us go over together?
There's four of us.
Oh. Well, if it'll make you happy, you can bring your little friend, too, okay?
Oh, yes.
No, it's not okay. Edie's gone out of her way all night to be nice to you two. But there's no need to play this game any longer. Edie, go ahead. Tell them what you've been too kind to say.
Whose car are we going in?
See how nice she is? She still won't say it, but I'm going to say it for her. With the possible exception of Kuda Johnson, you two are the most insensitive, surface, conceited excuses for men I've ever come across.
Oh, really? Is that what you think? Well, I'm not sitting here and taking that from you. Buck, let's get out of here. Maybe your new mom has a couple of friends.
I feel great. Edie, this is the first time I've ever told anyone off like that. I know you were watching, and I know what you were thinking.
I almost met Don Johnson.
You were thinking, did she listen to what I said this afternoon? Am I going to have to step in and tell these guys off? Well, you didn't have to, because I did listen. And you know, when Cuda gets back from Paris, I'm going to lay it out for him, too. He wants milk. Let him get it from Frank. And Edie, I won't even need you to be there.
Well, then the evening's been a success. Maybe I ought to get my filet in a bag. I gotta get up early for work tomorrow.
Listen, I've got this photo session coming up in London in a couple of weeks. And I'd sure like to have someone around I can trust and, well, have fun with. You know, like a gal Friday.
You want me to go to London with you? London, England, home of the Beatles.
It's not
much of a job.
Swings like a pendulum do.
Kind of like a personal secretary. Will you take it?
Look, Maris, you don't need a girl Friday. What you want is a friend.
Well, I guess that's what I'm really asking you to be.
Well, you don't have to buy one. It's not a job being your friend. I'd love to do that.
Thanks, Edie. Do you think you could help me find a personal secretary?
What are friends for? I'll take it.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna be great at this. I know I am. And the best part of all is you only have to tell me something once, and I got it. Where's the bathroom?
That way.
Got it. Waiter, could you make sure I get the check, please?
It's already been taken care of, miss.
Maris, how you doing?
Ray, how are you?
Listen, Wayne and I are out celebrating, being named two of the city's most eligible bachelors. Of course, we have no dates. So, you and your friend want to hit some late night spots?
Oh, I don't know. Edie and I are enjoying a night out by ourselves.
Oh, come on. Wayne really likes your friend.
Well, let me ask her.
We'll wait for you in the bar.
Listen, Edie, you want to go dancing?
What, you and me?
Well, it's your reputation.
No, these two guys, they're real.
Yes.
Great.
You know, thanks to you, good things are finally starting to happen to me. As of tonight, I really think my life is going to change.